we studied, there are a lot of investment opportunities and alternatives, and based on the investor's risk-taking ability, the tax sheltering that's being offered, the market structure, liquidity of shares, and all, we picked the different investment options. In the recent trend, one such investment option that is growing at a very large rate is initial public offering. So, like we've observed over the past 2-3 months, there have been a lot of very big companies that have been giving their IPOs to companies. So before all that, what is an IPO? What is an initial public offering? Like as Gopal said, if a private limited company would want to go public, if it wants to become a public limited company, it will open its shares for the public through a process called initial public offering. So before getting into this concept, let us see what a public and private limited company is. A private limited company is the one where there are a limited number of shareholders. That is, a maximum of 7 people can hold a share in a private limited company. Suppose the 7 people decide they cannot run the company autonomously, and if they decide that they want external support, they want more people in operating the company, then they will get into the process of launching it for public through IPO. So IPO is the process where a private limited company will sell its shares to public. This process generally happens in a window time of 10 days. About 10 to 15 days would be the window period for an IPO, where the company will sell its shares as allotments. Allotments are bulk of shares. It can be 10 shares, 20 shares in one allotment. So the client or the subscriber can pick any number of allotments that he or she wants. So IPOs do not happen as individual share units but as allotments. So once, say for example, let's consider Reliance Group. If it is going for an IPO, say Reliance is coming up with a grocery chain and it is launching it as an IPO. Maybe Reliance decides I give 1 lakh allotments. One allotment being 50 shares. So I sell one share at 20 rupees, 50 shares will be one allotment. So one allotment will be for 1000 rupees. So I am going to give out 1 lakh such allotments to the company. So if we happen to be the subscribers, we will go subscribe like I want 3 allotments, I want 10 allotments. Supposingly the number of subscribers exceeds 1 lakh. We call it a super subscription. So what do you think the company will do during a super subscription?
Maybe they will go for bidding.
Okay, they will go for bidding. Any other option? Okay, this is one very good point. Majority of the companies during an IPO launch, they will allot a particular number of shares or allotments for their own employees. For people working with Reliance Group will have 20 to 30% of its allotments. Tata will have 20 to 30% for Tata employees. So this is one way, and if an allotment gets super subscribed, either the company will go for bidding or it will be on a probability basis. So in a window of 2 or 3 days, the company will give away the allotments to the subscribers. The subscribers can hold the allotment for at least a week. There will be one particular release date that the company will tell also. On that release date, whatever be the market value of that particular allotment, the subscriber can either claim the stock for that market value. Like they can still hold the stock till the time that he wants to hold, maybe for another 2 months or 3 months, customer can still hold the share, or on the day of release, he may sell it off. So supposingly I get an allotment for 1000 rupees and its value has grown to 3500 during the release date. I may either sell it for 3500 or if I still have the risk-taking ability, still if you believe that after a week the value would grow higher or maybe in a month it will be even more higher, I can hold and sell it after that period also. So now I will become a owner of that particular company. So we understood what the concept of IPO is. Can you tell one IPO that was the biggest IPO that was recently launched?
Tata.
Good that all of you know. So what was Tata's allotment value?
13,500
per allotment. Can somebody tell me what the growth rate of Tata was? How is the Tata giveaway its allotment? It was close to 41,000. So almost 300% growth was there. So who do you think will get an allotment? What do you think will be the characteristic of an investor who is speaking for allotment? How would this risk-taking ability be? High risk-taking person, okay. So, higher the risk,
higher
the return. So IPO as of now is one such investment which will give the maximum return in a very short period of time. So even in the current week we had a lot of companies like Dom's gave in an IPO, and there's one renewable energy related company, I'm not very much aware of it. That company had given an IPO. We have IPOs coming on the 24th. We have two companies giving out their IPO during the Christmas period. So do you think an IPO would be an intelligent opportunity for people like you? For students who have minimum savings, like I shared 50,000 rupees here, I'm ready for an IPO. Do you think you can tell that? Why do you think an IPO would be? Okay, one is a short term problem. The second? You have a good knowledge of shares. For all that, didn't you understand IPO has the least amount that you have to invest? You need not invest in lakhs. You need not invest even 50,000. Even for 10,000, you can get one a lot. So 10,000 to 15,000, you'll be easily able to get one allotment provided the probability serves your purpose. So can you all start digging deep into this concept and learn more about IPO?
Yes.
Thank you everybody. I hope this class was helpful to you. I hope you learned about a new concept. Let us meet